It's amazing how one simple crafting technique opens the door to so many different ways to express yourself.
Hi, I'm Jen. I'd like to show you how to emboss and embellish this little block of clay in ways that you can use to later on make other personalized projects. If you make jewelry or scrapbook, you may already have some of the tools. All you'll need is a clay machine, embossing folder or stamp, a toolkit, a rolling pin, brushes and pigment powder, protective varnish, and of course, clay. Let's start by conditioning the clay. I'm using a modeling clay that I'll bake in the oven later. You can do this entirely by hand, and it's easiest to work the clay one half block at a time. Work the clay until it's warm and pliable. You can also condition the clay using a machine. Run the clay through the machine, fold it, turn it to keep the shape even, and run it through again. With either method, by hand or by machine, now you're ready to emboss. One method is to use the Cuddlebug embossing folders. These are available at JOANN in many sizes and designs. For mine, I've chosen the Spots and Dots folder. Press the folder firmly over the clay. Press just firmly enough to evenly impress the design. Roll it firmly and evenly. There's your design. For other embossing ideas, just look around you. You're surrounded by shapes and textures that are perfect for embossing clay. You can try items like lace, burlap, buttons, even things outside your home like brickwork and tree bark. And you can always create your own freehand designs. Just look around, discover, and trust your creativity. For the clay shape, it's easy to make a paper or cardboard template and just cut around it. Or for my coaster, I'll use this cookie cutter. And I'll save my other clay shape for later. The next step, which is familiar to any crafter, is adding color. I'll use metallic pigment powder. You can apply the powder directly to your clay using a brush and/or your finger. Now rub the powder to get a soft metallic finish. Here's another technique. Apply the powder directly to the stamp. You can see how just a little bit goes a long way. And I'm rubbing to make sure that it's evenly spread and tapping off the excess. Now press the stamp firmly into the clay. And this gives you a crisp, even design. Now bake according to package instructions and finish with a clear protective varnish. Try different brush sizes, stamps, colors, and impressions to find the look that's right for you. This simple technique, plus your own creative ideas, can lead to great gifts, decor, and jewelry. Here's a necklace embossed with burlap and embedded with tiny seed beads and a cute clay flower. These cards are embellished with clay monograms and flowers. This set of herb markers is embossed with real plant leaves and then hand inscribed. Be sure the leaves are fresh and strong. It's all in your hands, so just give it a try. You'll be amazed what you can do when you learn with JOANN.